So in today's video, we are going to discuss about the topic vapor pressure, and the subject we are dealing with is fluid mechanics. Okay, let's go to question number one. So the question is saying, when fluid in liquid state converts to gaseous state, the process is called as, okay. For example, we are having a container which is filled with liquid, let's say water, then it is getting converted into what? Gaseous state. Okay, a water sample getting converted into gaseous state, it will be converting itself into vapor. Okay, this specific process of conversion of liquid to gaseous state is called as what? Evaporation. Okay, now option B, condensation, means the reverse process of evaporation. If the vapor or if the substance in gaseous state is converting itself into liquid state, then it will be what? Condensation. Okay, and dispersion is something else. The best example of dispersion is placing a camphor tablet inside a closed box. What will happen? It will sublimate, it will turn into gaseous state, and the concentration of that gaseous state camphor will approach every open volume inside the box, and it will be spreading till the concentration of this gaseous state doesn't become equal in all the places. Okay, this is what? Process of dispersion. Liquid to gas is evaporation, then gaseous state to liquid state is condensation, then dispersion is the process of a gas occupying volumes or gas occupying void inside a box, inside a closed container, till its concentration doesn't become same in all the places, all the corners, all the nook and cranny of the box. It is called a dispersion. Okay, let's go to question number next then. Okay, condensation is the process of, it is the reversal of evaporation. Okay, it is simply conversion of a fluid from its gaseous state to liquid state. Okay, if vapor is condensing over a surface and then the vapor will turn into water, it is what? The process of condensation. Okay, option B is the correct one. Conversion of fluid from gaseous state to liquid state. Okay, gaseous to liquid. Option B is the one. Alright, let's go to question number next. Molecules that escape surface of liquid in a closed container exert a pressure on the liquid which is known as, is it vapor pressure, condensation pressure, fluid pressure or surface pressure? Let's see. Let's say we are having a container which is filled up with, let's say, water and or any liquid. Okay, for our example we are considering water. Then what will happen? Some molecules are going to evaporate, some molecules are going to get converted into vapor. Okay, now these vapor bubbles, these vapors are going to occupy the void space which is above the liquid surface, which is above the liquid film. Now this vapor which has been there inside the open volume of the box, of the container, will exert some kind of pressure over the film surface. Okay, over the film or over the surface. This specific pressure is called as what? Vapor pressure. Pressure exerted by the vapor of the liquid when the liquid is stored in a closed container is called as what? Vapor pressure. Okay, let's go to question number next then. Alright, with increase in the temperature of a liquid, the molecular activity, fill in the blank, and vapor pressure, fill in the blank. What happens when we are increasing the temperature of a liquid? What happens to the molecular activity? What happens to the vapor pressure? Again, we will go with our same container which is filled up with what? A liquid. Specifically, water we are speaking about here is. Okay. Then what will happen if we somehow increase the temperature by providing external flame or somehow increasing the temperature by any practical means? What is going to happen? The molecular activity is going to increase. The molecule will gain momentum, and with the increased energy they are going to escape this liquid state. Okay, they are going to evaporate, and what is going to happen? More evaporation means more vapor, more vapor means more occupying of the volume which is present inside the container, and this total volume of vapor is going to exert pressure on the liquid film or liquid surface. Okay, then more the vapor pressure will be there. Okay, more the heat, more will be the activity, molecular activity, and more vapor will be there. And since more vapor will be there, more vapor pressure will be there. Alright, therefore, the most suitable option here is increases, comma increases, which is option C. Okay, let's just revise this thing. With increase in the temperature of a liquid, the molecular activity increases and vapor pressure increases. Okay. Now let's go to question number next. Okay. Irrespective of the temperature, a liquid can be made to transform into gaseous state by. Okay, let's see. Again, this container, again the liquid, and let's say the liquid is water, that is H2O. Okay, now what is going to happen? In order to make the liquid turn into its gaseous state, what we have to do? We have to increase the temperature, we have to provide heat. Then and only then what is going to happen? This water will get converted into vapor. But we have been stated with the thing that irrespective of the temperature, means even at a room temperature, let's say at 20 degrees Celsius, we can make the liquid to boil. We can literally boil the liquid. Okay, how? We now just have established the fact that when we are saying that a vapor pressure is being exerted, it is the pressure where the transformation, the conversion of a liquid into its vapor state takes place. Now, what we will do? We will make the pressure inside this container such that it is less than the external pressure. Okay, whatever be the external atmospheric or whatever be the external absolute pressure which is getting exerted over the container, what we will do? We will make the external absolute pressure less than the vapor pressure. Now, if we make the external absolute pressure less than the vapor pressure or exactly equal to the vapor pressure, therefore the condition of transforming a liquid into its vapor state or into its gaseous state will be established. The only thing we have to maintain is that we have to make the external absolute pressure less than or equal to vapor pressure. Okay, now there are two ways by which we can convert a liquid into its gaseous state. First one is provide heat to the liquid so that it will convert itself into gaseous state, or don't worry about the heat, just try to make the external absolute pressure on the container equal to or less than the vapor pressure of that specific liquid. What will happen then? The condition for transformation of liquid to gaseous will be established, and then we can literally boil the liquid or make the liquid into its gaseous state irrespective of temperature. Okay, understood? Now let's take the correct answer. What we just said, without worrying about the temperature, if we make the external absolute pressure less than or equal to vapor pressure, what we can do? We can boil the liquid, or we can simply transform the liquid into its gaseous state. Okay, with this, let's go to question number next. This condition, the required condition for a liquid to boil even at room temperature is, what we have to do? We have to make the external absolute pressure less than or equal to vapor pressure, that is VP, vapor pressure of that liquid. Okay, therefore what is the condition? External imposed pressure, external absolute pressure should be less than or equal to what? Vapor pressure. And if we somehow succeed in making this condition possible, then what will happen? This liquid is going to boil, this liquid is going to transform itself from its liquid state to gaseous state. All right, let's go to question number next. In a closed conduit, when vaporization starts due to pressure inside being less than vapor pressure, what happens? First thing, the liquid transforms into gaseous phase. Yes, very much correct. Then pockets of vapor bubbles form. Yes, these pockets are going to form, this vapor bubble pockets will be then implying, will be then imposing a pressure on the liquid film again, which is called as what? Vapor pressure. Okay, this specific point, pockets of vapor pressure, vapor bubble form, is important in the topic cavitation, that we are going to discuss in the next video. Okay, therefore, since both the things are correct here, we will go with the most correct option, which should be both of the above. Alright, let's go to question number next. Vapor pressure is the pressure at which cavitation in a hydraulic machine starts. B. Liquid transforms into gaseous phase. C. Vapor pressure is absolutely the pressure at which liquid transforms into gaseous phase. But the point A, the option A stated here is saying cavitation in a hydraulic machine start. Yes. Cavitation does start because vapor pressure phenomenon take place, vapor bubble take place, but it is not necessary that starting or initiation of vapor pressure being less than the, no, initiation of the vapor pressure concept is going to totally start cavitation. The phenomenon may take place, but cavitation requires one or two more conditions along with the vapor pressure concept, then and only then cavitation will start. Vapor pressure alone cannot initiate cavitation. Okay, that we are going to discuss in the next video. Okay, for now, vapor pressure, the only thing that we know about vapor pressure is liquid transform into gaseous phase. For cavitation to take place, there are more conditions along with vapor pressure. Okay, that's why sufficient answer, the most correct scenario that the question is making with respect to option here is liquid transforms into gaseous phase. That's why both of the above gets ruled out, none of the above gets ruled out, and option A is not the correct or perfect scenario with respect to the question being asked. Okay. So that was all regarding vapor pressure. In the next lecture, we are going to cover some questions regarding cavitation. Till then, like the video, comment below your suggestions, subscribe to Simplified Learning, and take care. Bye-bye.